So here's something that happens every once in a while. You get a video file that won't open in QuickTime. Maybe it's an old video file from years ago. Maybe it's something you've just downloaded or somebody gave to you. Here's a file here. You can see it's .avi, which is an old Windows video format. I'm going to double click it, and sure enough, it tries to open a QuickTime player and then gives me an error. QuickTime player is great for opening most modern video formats, but some older ones and some more obscure ones, it just doesn't handle very well. So most Mac users have an app on their Mac called VLC that they use for this. And you can get VLC at videoland.org, and that's the company that produces it. You go there to VLC to download, and you get the VLC media player. And this is a very common app. It's been around for a long time. And it does a variety of things, but one of the main things it does is allow you to play this kind of video. So I've got the VLC player installed. I'm going to control click and say open with, and you can see I get a QuickTime player is the default, but there's a variety of other things including the VLC app which I've installed. Here you can see it plays that video no problem at all. When it's done playing, you can see the main VLC interface here, which is actually a playlist. So you could drag and drop many different videos here and then have them play in order. But you can add other types of media as well. So you could actually use VLC as a music player, also putting different audio files in here or a mixture of them. I could also convert this video file so it could be in a more modern format. So I can go to File, Convert Stream. I drag and drop the file there. I already did that previously, so it's there. I can select format, so I'm going to choose a really standard H.264 format. It's the one at the top. I can customize it further if I want with all sorts of details. I can browse and choose a location and then hit save, and it will save it out. You can see the progress there, and in the end I'm going to get this M4V file, really standard format. Now that was created in VLC, so it will open up in VLC if I double click it, but if I control click it and say open with, you can see I can open it in QuickTime Player now very easily. And there it is. So now it's a standard format. So you can convert as well as play. VLC also has a bunch of other very useful things that you could do. You can capture the screen. You can capture it from your camera. You can convert to audio. All sorts of different things. So you may want to look into that further, but for now it's just a useful tool to have if you've got some video files that won't play in QuickTime Player.